Hello, Chris Robinson, 6'2", 130 pounds, USA, the Black Crowes, rock and roll band. Peace.
Ah, I'm into it. Now, we call this jealous again.
Thank you.
My brother and I just, you know, started playing, and like anything else, one step leads to another, and found the other people, and we made a really serious commitment to our music, a commitment that comes before, you know, health, mental and physical, family, you know, anything else that comes up and down the road, if you will. We, you know, you put it before that, and just making the next thing you know, you're in a band and you're playing clubs and you're doing your own thing, and then people are shoving contracts in your face, and then all this mess kind of happens. And we don't analyze it that much ourselves. Maybe we fill a void. I mean, I think we represent a lot of things that have been lacking and missing for a long time, you know. Just substance and style, you know what I'm saying? Both things together. But then again, you could probably ask our fans. They would probably know better than we do.
Ooh, yeah, yeah. See, I'm Rich Robinson, right? Yeah. Oh, yeah. about your chastity.
There's no other way to be, really, you know, it's, you ask me, I'll tell you, you know, I grew up thinking that telling the truth was like a virtue, you know, living your life honestly, taking everything from here and here head on, that's just what, you know, like, that's what we apply to our music and our band, because we don't separate the two. Well, you know, I mean, when it's like when you start your band, it's you against the world, you know, and we still have that attitude. There's no room to be complacent just because you've sold a few million copies of your record. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm sure the Banana Splits, you know, Saturday morning cartoon record sold millions of copies when it came out.
Where are they now?
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I mean, like, if it was, I guess, but see, to some people, they get so wrapped up into how many records they sell. But to us, it's important to make good music, you know?
This next song is on that record of ours, Shakin' Moneymaker. And the plot of this song is based loosely around this story. Let's say you wake up one morning and you go to the cupboard to get some coffee and you're out. You stub your toe on the way back to the bedroom. By the time you get to the bedroom, you look in the bed and you say to yourself, what kind of fucking asshole am I sleeping with? So with that beautiful cinnamon in mind, I'd like to get on to this. We call this Seeing Things for the Very First Time. Or maybe it's not about that at all, really. Yeah, man. That's cool. At home to shed a tear. You brought it on yourself, my dear. And wrong, yes, I may be. Don't you dare, don't you dare, baby, leave a light on for me. Home, even though it hurts me, baby, to be by myself all alone. Yeah, baby, really, 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 really hurts me. My poor pitiful heart Eddie Hodge from Toronto, Canada.
Success for us means, that's a weird word anyway, it's really freed our hands more to where Rich and I really can dig down deep and get a little more out there and really, you know, try to, as far as songwriters, you know, there's no, we're not very complacent with our neighborhood we're living in now. I don't think we ever will be. That's, we don't take it very casually. Those are our songs, you know? That's what we show people. That's our work. That's why we think we can tell, you know, that's why we think, you know, we speak our minds and tell you our things. Our music, you know, we get on stage every night and back it up. Every night for 16 months. We're not done yet, you know? So it's, it's almost a shame that, well, definitely a shame that we're such a novelty out there. As far, you know, you could almost call it that. Wow, bold, you know? Isn't that unbelievable that that music has turned into that?
Thank you. Is that something that's
it's not something that we ever like kind of set out to do, and I don't think you would get that feeling if we had. It would be contrived. You are what you play, and you play what you are. There should be no pretensions, you know. When I get on stage as like the front man, what I do during the show, it's not like a premeditated, wow, during this song I'm gonna go over here and do this, and you know, I don't have time for that. That's Las Vegas, you know, and I think Las Vegas is disgusting. I just don't like the place, you know. So it's such a sad thing, really, that being an honest, living, breathing rock and roll band that makes you think and makes you tingly from the waist down, and you know, all of it combined, you know, is such a novel thing in 1991. That's pretty sad, really, you know, that there's only the one, the way some, you know, that's what some people say. It just goes to show you, and I think things probably will turn around. You know, you just have to wonder what motivates a lot of these bands. The sheer fact that we wrote the songs and that we made people feel a certain way, and that, you know, that makes me feel great, you know, that keeps your confidence level up, and that makes, you know, if you lose it, you know, that makes you realize that, wow, it's real, you know what I'm saying? Like, this whole thing is real. It's very real. And it just helps you to the next logical step, you know?
Who would you say your influences are musically and for your writing?
Well, there's so many, you know? I mean, and I don't even know if it sticks with music, that it's so hard to say. You know, I mean, like, there's the obvious musical ones, but then there's the ones that aren't obvious, you know, like Sly and the Family Stone, even. But then again, there's, like, the Emperor Nero, you know, somehow that he's probably an inspiration. Rock and roll music is ethnic music. It encompasses
you know, all sorts of music, you know, folk music from everywhere, from black music and, you know, country music. So many, you know, that you can't really pigeonhole yourself into, like, well, this is what I play, three-chord rock and roll. Well, that's not what we do. We play ethnic music, it's a kind of a traditional music. We play it in an untraditional way, We're a cog in the machine, but maybe, you know, that cog can make the machine run a little different, you know? Why not? Rules were made to be broken. I'm trying to kill rock and roll off since its inception, and I can't worry about the music industry, you know? I'm worried about my teeth falling out and, you know, if I'm going to get to talk to my girlfriend on the phone when I get back to the hotel and... You know what I'm saying? Making sure that Terry Reed, you know, if I can find a Terry Reed record on CD or something. You know, the music industry, worrying about that is like worrying about Wall Street or something.
Well, yeah, if you heard our record, you know, at the end of it there's a little piece of music if you let it play all the way out. And now that piece of music is a song called Live Too Fast Blues, Mercy Sweet Moan. And that's what we're going to do.
Yeah, well, we find ourselves really not putting much much faith in like success or whatever, you know, or what people perceive it to be. Because it's nice and everything, but it's really not why we got into it. And it's really the sort of thing that if you get wrapped up in it, it's the kind of thing that, you know, we do want to continue making records and to kind of grow up in this band. And if you get wrapped up in the sort of success aspect of it, then when it's over, you know, I guess it hurts more or something, you know. It's just something we don't really think about that much. We showed up to play the game and to win, you know. I mean, we're not, you know, we didn't get it about this to be mediocre people, just to let other people do mediocre things, you know. I don't think that's like an unbelievably arrogant like attitude to have. It's just that you know, it's like your music history, you know, we know it, but that doesn't mean that just because other people made great records and wrote great songs that move people doesn't mean that you can't, you know? And if you happen to sell truckloads of records doing it, good, you know? But if not, you know, I used to have a fun when we played to 12 people, and I have fun when we play to 12,000 or whatever, you know?
Never mentions the word addiction. In certain company, yes, I tell you she is a lover. Lock of hair in her pocket. Yes, she wears a cross around her neck. And in case you did not know, the hair is from a little boy. And the cross from someone that she has not met. No, not yet. She pulls the shades right down tight. thank you very much.